Yeah, hi, my name is Pawan. I am from a company called Agile Solutions. So we are trying to build safe factories and safe workplaces. So let us try to first understand what is the real problem, right? So industrial safety is not a problem which has started today, right? It is there from the time man started doing something. There are hazards associated with every activity, right? So even with so much technology and automation around in industries and workplaces, still this many number of people get injured every year in their workplace, and they are severely affected by workplace and occupational hazards, which leaves like their after retirement life also impact. So I was working in coal mines for around 4 years in government of Telangana. I see a lot of people, see the life expectancy of a people working in the coal mine, and previously I was working in L&T. So let us say an operator or a forklift operator in L&T definitely outlives a forklift operator working in Coal India or in Sikkim. I can guarantee, because the type of environment they are exposed to, the type of hazards they are exposed to, and the type of impact it leaves on their life is very phenomenal. Though we may not be very aware of it, because we might not be interacting with them daily. So workplace hazards are a very phenomenal thing, and it has huge impact on people's life. So that is what I want to tell. Other than that, what is the business aspect? Like, why do companies have to think about workplace safety rather than their productivity and what losses it can occur? So it comes with a hidden cost. Let us say you have a skilled drill machine operator who operates a lathe machine or something. Let us say he got injured. So you have to find alternate guy to do the operation. You have to train somebody else to do that operation. And it causes lost morale in the people. And the most important thing which companies have not come to yet is understanding the strategic gap. Right, let us say company in their board meeting might sit and tell, so this year we are going to spend some 10% of our thing on safety this year. But how do they come to that figure? Like gathering the data of near misses and the accident chances. So near miss is basically like, let us say you are going on a bike and you went very close to a car, which accident was supposed to happen but you missed. Like, so these kind of things happen in factory. Like things stop, fall, like they can go and hit, and accidents might happen but they got missed. But how do you capture this data? Unless you capture this data, how you will know how many chances of operation accidents are going to happen? Right? So that is a huge strategic gap in understanding where to invest in safety. Right? Do we have to buy them better helmets? Or do we have to like train people more to operate safely? Where do we invest to keep our workplaces safer? Yeah, how do we solve this problem? So safety is not a new problem, as I have told. There are organizations like ISO, ILO, OSHA and all bringing in safety standards, and there is a safe operating procedure for every activity. Right from the way a labor is supposed to lift a brick to the way a complex rig machine should be operated on a onshore facility. So there is an SOP for everything. But who is making sure the SOP is followed all the time? Right? You tell your worker who is operating a hand drill machine that you are supposed to wear your helmet, you are supposed to wear your eye gear, and you are supposed to wear your hand gloves and operate the machine. So in case there is an accident, you will be saved from it. Right? But who is making sure that this guy is following all these activities whenever he is operating the drill machine? That is very difficult to follow. What HackLab is trying to do is, we believe this safety problem can be solved with three approaches. One is connected devices, where you monitor whether the person is correctly doing the operation or not, and understand what activity he is doing, and is he wearing the right gear or not to do the operation, and is he the right guy to do that operation in the first place. Right? You don't want your forklift operator or a contractor employee to go and operate very crucial machine. Right? So that is one part of it. And cloud visualization, where in real time you can invoke and revoke the access to machinery and facility. Let us say you have a furnace facility and all. You don't want people who are not aware of the safety hazards near a melting furnace to walk in that room, right? So dynamically you should be able to invoke and revoke access to people to machinery and facilities. Other than that, advanced machine to machine communications which can be retrofitted. So in a process industry, so operations change dynamically, right? So during one operation, so let us say on the same day, so when I was working in L&T, I'll give you an example of a foundry. Right, when molding is happening, most of the time furnace activity might not be happening. Right, so when molding or people are working in the molding thing, when people are making the mold, so the furnace is on or furnace is off. So depending on the operation, you can control number of people, and you need to have this communication between machine to person and person to machine also, to understand whether the guy is coming to the machine or is the machine operational, or the guy can go to machine in this state of operation. So that is how we believe this problem can be solved. And what have we done so far is we came up with this product called SafeMet. So SafeMet is a smart helmet which monitors whether the guy is really wearing the helmet or not. It can track the guy within the facility. The SafeMet can talk to machines around him. So let me give you an example. So the same use case which I was talking about, right? The handrail machine operator. Or let me take an example of a forklift operator. So for a forklift operator, what SafeMet can do is, so without wearing the helmet, the guy will not be able to start the forklift itself. It talks to the seat belt also. It talks to the foot switch also. Right? These three equipment are very crucial on the forklift. So the SOP says the guy is supposed to wear the seat belt, put his helmet, and then start the forklift. So any of this is violated, the forklift itself will not start, making the possibility of an unsafe activity closer to zero. So that is our approach to safety. So SafeMet is the first product which we have launched, which can detect the real-time information of the person and track whether he is wearing the helmet or not. So let us say in a construction kind of setting, you can monitor how many people are working with helmets and they are not working without helmets. Can be really monitored, and that information can be sent to safety officer. So why we have chosen helmet as our first product is head injuries are very serious and they can cause huge damages. Other than that, helmet goes everywhere. Any industry, helmet is a basic PPE. Like right from construction to mining to any industry. That is one reason, and it can go to any industry. And SafeMet has already built-in interfaces to communicate with machinery around it. So what is the market size? So stats say that VHS market size is around $49.8 billion in 2015, and helmet market alone comes to around $2.1 billion. So what is our business model? So SafeMet is not the only product. Actually, we have around 7 to 8 products which act together as a solution, right? So let us say you are putting helmet on the SafeMet on the person, and you are supposed to put some other equipment on the machinery to communicate with him. Right, this is how this whole solution builds. So we have developed technologies using these SafeMet and other products for real-time people and asset tracking, collision avoidance systems between machine to machines, and pedestrian alert systems. Like whenever a pedestrian is walking, whenever he goes closer to an overhead crane, it sends an alert to the overhead crane and stops it. As long as the person goes away from there, the overhead crane will not stop. That can be done with any moving machinery for that case. Biometric authentication of the employees is PPE detection and access control. PPE is primary protective equipment, like gloves, helmet and all. Let us say you have a warehouse, unless the guy comes with shoe and helmet, he will not be allowed into the warehouse only. So all the listed solutions are built with the same motto of safe by design. Other than that, HackLab was an innovation space which was started in 2015. We were encouraging people to come up with hardware ideas and work with us. So in 2017, we turned into HackLab Solutions from HackLab Innovations. And we got our first client from Facebook for people tracking. Then in Unilever, we have deployed a couple of projects of collision avoidance and prediction alert systems. Then, so closely now we have more than 35 orders we have executed, and our products are working in more than 11 factories. This is our revenue. The first year when we started, we made 20 lakhs. Then we made 60 lakhs. This year we are planning to make around 1.5 crore. So more than 30 lakhs we have made this year. Probably we will close that figure. So this is a video, but I don't think we have time to go through that. So what are we planning to do in future is smart logo, smart PV, auto safe audit. And competitors are GuardHat, Angel Helmet, Strong Arm Tech. So our go-to market strategy is we want to have partnership with OEM. Currently we have with YALE. We are going to have a partnership with Godrej to put their material handling equipment. And this is my team. And this is the amount we are trying to raise to scale up, get certification to our products, spend more in our R&D, and get certifications is the major thing which we are looking, because we see a global market for this, and to enter into global market, certifications for hardware is very crucial.